Having $1 million does not make you wealthy. Having money left over at the end of the month is what truly makes you wealthy. My name is Carmen.
And I'm Darius. And a recent article published by The Motley Fool illustrated just this very thing. People who make $100,000, 30% of them were living paycheck to paycheck. Mm-hmm. So if they got paid on Friday, by the time they received their next paycheck, 30% of them had already run out of money. Now, even when it comes to people that make even more money, let's say $200,000, 32% of those people were broke by the time they received their next paycheck. So this just goes to illustrate that having more money doesn't solve the problem. There's a bigger issue that we need to take into consideration.
Yes. Now, the story really begins with understanding what wealth is. And when we talk about having extra money at the end of the month, it's really because you're living within your means and you're not living paycheck to paycheck. So as Darius and I became more responsible with our money, we recognized that having an extra $200, $300, $400, $500, $1,000 every single month was really what changed our lifestyle. Because once we paid ourselves first, then paid our expenses, and still had disposable income, that's really what allowed us to create the lifestyle and to design the lifestyle that we desired for ourselves. So we don't want you to get stuck in what society is portraying, and having millions of dollars is what's going to change your life. It's the extra money that you have at the end of the month is what really makes you wealthy.
Right, because you can be a millionaire, and if you're living paycheck to paycheck, you're no different than someone that's making $40,000 a year. So the key here is understanding exactly what wealth is. Now, wealth is having an abundance of financial possessions or having an abundance of physical assets. That's exactly what wealth is.
Now, don't get overwhelmed with abundance, though, because remember, and what is an abundance to you? An abundance to you may be $500, or an abundance to someone else may be $1,000. So abundance doesn't necessarily mean that you need eight figures to change your lifestyle. You just need a little extra cash on hand. And having an abundance which directly correlates to your income is what makes you wealthy. Again, keep that in mind.
Now, just to reiterate what Carmen said, you don't have to have $1 million to be considered wealthy or rich. What you have to have is more money left over after you've taken care of all of your expenses, including paying yourself, because you yourself personally is an expense. Now, how are you going to go about doing this is actually having a plan for your lifestyle. So for example, if your expenses are $5,000 a month and you make $6,000, that additional $1,000 means you have 20% more than what you need. You have a 20% in abundance of what it actually costs you to live on a monthly basis. So you would be considered wealthy.
And in addition to being considered wealthy, it's also understanding how money works. Some people can't get to this point because they don't understand how money works. So what we definitely recommend that you do is click on the link below to check out our masterclass, because we teach you how money works and how to design your lifestyle so that you can become your own source of financing instead of relying on the banks.
Right. Now, money is just a tool for you to design your lifestyle. That's why we always talk about owning your own lifestyle, because you have to put this tool to work for you. What wealthy people are doing, they're utilizing this tool to create passive income, which is the second point that we want to start getting into right now.
Yeah, and passive income is about, what are you doing with the extra money that you have every single month? So are you spending it irresponsibly, or using that money to make more money? And we hope it's that one. You're using that money to make more money. So don't just think, oh, now I have the opportunity to go on vacation, or oh, I have the opportunity to now buy more clothes. No, let's make that money make more money. Put that money to work so that from the passive income that you're generating, the money that you're flipping, that money can fund your vacations and your clothing and whatever the case may be. Let that money go out to work for you and bring in more friends. Bring more friends to the party, right?
Right.
Because you want to 10x your efforts. Work smarter, not harder. So allow your money to work for you. That's all what passive income is, because with passive income, you are not physically trading time for money. That money is out working for you, working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and it's just bringing in more friends so that you can really afford to live the lifestyle that you want.
Right. So personal finance, which is you understanding how much money that you have to maintain your lifestyle, and the extra that you have left over is the abundance that can make you wealthy. Now, the other part to that is the passive income. So, there's personal finance and passive income that goes hand in hand if you want to start changing your financial lifestyle and your financial journey. Mm-hmm. This is how you own your own lifestyle, by putting your money to work, generating assets through passive income.
All right, now let's get into point number three, which is replacing the depositor. And what we mean by this is we want someone else to deposit money into your bank, hence passive income, instead of you making sure that that's happening. Because we want to replace active income and create more passive income. When you are working, meaning training time for money, you are the one going out and making sure that those deposits are happening. But we want to create passive income so you can replace the depositor, replace you as a depositor in your bank account. So whatever assets that you are creating for yourself, whether it be digital assets or hard assets or side hustles that you have going on, definitely make sure that you are having Susie Q, John Doe, John B, Frank Smith, whoever it is, pay you on a monthly basis. So now they're the ones who are generating the income for you, and it's not you creating the income for yourself.
Right, because let's think about the system in which we put our deposit our money into the bank. The banks are using us as a source of passive income because they physically don't have to go out and put money into the bank themselves. Oh. That's what we're doing.
Yeah.
And what are they doing with our money? They're creating more passive income because they're lending this money out.
Yes.
So how do we generate this same system for ourselves? Well, first of all, we have to replace ourselves as the depositor. We replace the banking system, which is what infinite banking is all about. And then we utilize those funds to generate more passive income.
Exactly.
This is how we start to become wealthy. This is how we start to do the things that wealthy people do.
We're not even reinventing the wheel here, ladies and gentlemen. We're literally just showing you what to do with the extra money that you have, which is what wealthy people are doing. Remember, wealthy people don't have to be millionaires. Wealthy people are the people who know how money works and are flipping money to make more money. So keep that into perspective, and also realize that sometimes you have to start somewhere. You have to crawl before you can walk, and being able to flip a few hundred bucks every single month is huge for you, right? Because that's just going to grow into something else that's going to allow you to flip more money on a monthly basis. So do not get overwhelmed or feel discouraged if you only have a small pot of money to play with. That pot of money will grow into a really nice chunk of money one day.
Exactly. And that small pot of money can mean the world of a difference for you and your personal situation. Don't compare your situation to somebody else's, because everybody's lifestyle is different. Mm-hmm. And just like we shared in the beginning in this video, you can make $200,000 a year and still be living paycheck to paycheck.
Yeah. Don't let the media fool you. Don't let social media fool you, because it's really about money management. It's not how much money you make. It's about how much money you keep. So keep that in a perspective, ladies and gentlemen, because the reason why you're watching this video, or the reason why you're going out there and looking for other financial resources to start helping you own your own lifestyle, is because you don't currently know how, or you're maybe doing something incorrectly. So that's why we're here. That's why we're here for you on the Wealth Nation channel, is to continue to educate you about how to go about either one, creating passive income, or two, becoming your own source of financing and controlling the banking functions in your life. So again, if this is something that interests you, then definitely click on the link below to check out our masterclass.
And make sure you check out our next video, The Secret to Not Being Broke.
And if you like this video, make sure that you like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to own your own lifestyle,
or someone else will.